Welcome to weekdaychurch.com. Thanks for joining us. Today, we're going to be talking about how weakness can be masked as a strength. You can look real strong in something, but really you're hiding an enormous area of weakness. And that's what we're going to see. We're going to spend this entire week in the first 20 verses of chapter 5 of Mark. Our passage of scripture today is going to be Mark chapter 5, verses 1 through 5. They came to the other side of the sea, to the country of the Gerasenes. And when Jesus had stepped out of the boat, immediately there met him, out of the tombs, a man with an unclean spirit. He lived among the tombs, and no one could bind him anymore, not even with a chain. For he had often been bound with shackles and chains, but he wrenched the chains apart, and he broke the shackles in pieces. No one had the strength to subdue him. Night and day among the tombs and on the mountains, he was always crying out and cutting himself with stones. Our Heavenly Father, we want to just say today, we love you. You rescue us when we're at our lowest point. When we're helpless and needy, you come to us. Whether it's the first time and we're born again in salvation, or whether it's the countless times after we're even your children that we need you and you're here for us. We worship, we adore you, we love you. Prepare our hearts and minds for the message that you have for us today. Thank you that we can come together in your presence. Bless this work in Jesus' name I pray. Amen. So we see here that we've got a man who cannot be bound, cannot be subdued. No matter how they tie him up, he looks extraordinarily strong. You're watching this guy and he just tears through the chains, he breaks through things. No matter how much you tie him down, you can put him in iron stocks and he's just going to bust through them. He lives out in the caves and you can't tie him up and you can't stop him. But then as you read, you see that night and day, he's in the tombs. He's on the mountains, and he's crying out and cutting himself with stones. You see, one of the things that makes me laugh is a really big man who's strong and spends all kinds of time in the gym, and you can tell he probably works out an hour and a half a day, And the first time somebody ever says something to him, he sort of cringes and jumps and looks like he's scared. A lot of the biggest guys I know like that are often, you know, controlled by their mothers or controlled by their wives. And the first thing she says, he's sort of like, "Oh, yes, ma'am," you know, and that kind of a thing. And I laugh because you see such a physical specimen, but emotionally you see such a wimp inside of that person, and it seems like they're so overcompensating, and it's so funny to me every time I watch something like that, and then later they sort of buff up and show you how strong they are, and you think, yeah, it's too late, man, it's too funny. And you watch this guy in this story, and all week we're going to be talking about him and how Jesus helps him and the emotional side of this. And as we go through this week and we look at emotional health and how Jesus comes to deliver us, as that song was saying earlier, but not just spiritually. And we often pray for physical healing. I think one of the things we need to add to our prayer times, to our prayer list, as much as anything, and for some reason we hide in shame when we talk about this, is emotional healing. Jesus came, we're going to mention this each day, that Jesus came to emotionally heal this man. Physically, he was a beast. He was strong. He was powerful. No one could stop this guy. He sounded like Samson. He was just so strong. But emotionally, he was such a mess. Crying day after day, night after night, cutting himself with stones, in constant pain, hurting, lonely, scared. And Jesus came to deliver him and to bring him emotional health, emotional freedom. You say, what's the point? I want you to catch something here. We're going to see tomorrow, and we're going to get into this a little more through the week, that this was a man that was possessed by spirits. So many, many evil spirits possessed this man. And I want you to catch something here. The spirit that was in him, the spirits that were in him, gave him physical strength. I want you to look back to Samson, whether it be evil spirits or good spirits. Samson was not necessarily physically strong. We always draw him as a big, enormous, strong man. Well, there's no reason to do that. It never says in the text that he was a big guy. We just sort of equate that. The Bible makes it clear he received his power because the Holy Spirit was on him. He did things that no human, no matter how big he is, could have done. He did not do these in his own power. He did them through the Spirit in him. The spirits, legion, that were in this man made him physically strong. He might have been a small man for all we know, but he has this enormous physical strength because of them. I want you to catch something here. The physical strength that you receive from a spirit. We often say, God, pray for me. I want my knees to feel better. I want the cancer to go away. I want this. I want that. And we so often, if you go to prayer meetings, they're almost all for physical request. But many people we know are much more hurting emotionally than they've ever hurt physically. And the same spirits that can go in you and provide you physical strength can provide you emotional strength. God's Spirit can come into you and heal you emotionally, can give you health. You can look online and you can read the statistics of how many people out there deal with emotional difficulties, deep depression, not temporary sadness, deep depression, schizophrenia, bipolar, on and on the list goes. Kids that are struggling with attention deficit disorder, and we say, there's medicines for these, and thank God for medicine. But what we would really love to see is true healing. And the Holy Spirit can heal. The Spirit that comes into us can make us full of the fruit of the Spirit, and we can be full of peace and joy. And these things that are tearing us down and holding us back can be built into our lives, not by trying harder, but by the Holy Spirit's presence in our lives. So what do we need to do? We need to receive the Holy Spirit. If you're here today and you're not saved and you don't know Jesus Christ, you need the same thing the man in this story needed. The first thing you need to do, you will not have the Holy Spirit in your life if you do not have Jesus Christ in your life. It is the Spirit of Jesus. The Spirit flows from the Father and from the Son. If you do not have the Son, you do not have the Father or the Spirit. You need to accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. You just need to ask Him to come into your heart to save you from your sins. And when you do, you will receive the Holy Spirit. Most of us watching this know Jesus Christ, though. We are Christians. But there are times that we have grieved or quenched the Holy Spirit's fire. We have lived in sin, and so the Spirit's not working powerfully in us. And our emotions have fallen to pieces. Why? Because we're living in sin. Or we've quenched the Holy Spirit, and we've put God in a box. And we say, why am I so torn up? Well, we've not allowed God to move in these areas of our lives. And if you want that emotional freedom and emotional health, you need to give the Holy Spirit complete control over your life. Even as a Christian, you can hold him back. And I encourage you not to do that. Let God start moving in your life, because you can be physically strong. You can be spiritually saved. And you can be an emotional wreck. But God wants to change that. And I ask you to allow him to start working in that area of your life. We'll talk more about how to do that as we go throughout this week. Will you pray with me as we have our closing blessing? Heavenly Father, we pray that you will begin to work and continue to work in our emotional lives. Bring us strength, peace, bring us joy and happiness. In the name of Jesus and through the power of your Holy Spirit, I pray this. Amen. Our closing song today is going to be Mighty to Save. You know, God is mighty to save you in every area of your life, so that you can love him with your heart and your soul, as well as your mind and strength, so that you can give God your all. Thanks for worshiping with us today. Hope to see you again tomorrow.
Everyone needs compassion, a love that's never failing. Let mercy